All right, guys, so we're here. It's, I guess we'd be 8 days out now from the Arnold. So we fly out next Tuesday. I think like Athens being everything's Thursday, and then I'm on stage Saturday morning and Saturday evening. So yeah, we're like 8 days, things are getting pretty close now. So, you know, I'm definitely starting to feel that I've been dieting for like 6+ months now. You know, I'm very happy with the look and my strength and how everything's going training wise, but you know, you just definitely start to feel like mentally and you're starting to get a little sluggish at this point, so. But I mean, it's the old saying of like the worse you feel, the better you look kind of thing. So I'm just trying to latch onto that statement and hope it's true, right? So, but yeah, me and Melissa are here today, 8 days out for me, and we're like, what, 5 weeks out for you? She'll be 5 weeks out tomorrow. She's going to be doing the
Hurricane Pro
in St. Petersburg, Florida, which is October 23rd. So this will be the first time she's been on stage in like almost 3 years. So this is really big deal, and it's, you know, really cool and really fun. So yeah, we're all really excited. I mean, she put on her heels in posing suit or practice suit for the first time in like legit 3 years yesterday. So, you know, it's like new, and you know, you're like a baby deer standing on those heels, like, you know, a little fresh legs. So, but it's fun, it's exciting, and it's like kind of a whole new thing right now. So it's kind of cool. You know?
Yeah, I feel like a virgin competitor.
Yeah.
I feel like I've never done it before.
Yeah.
It's really exciting.
So it's gonna be a lot of fun. I'm so excited to see her back on stage. So yeah, that's cool. Also want to announce as well, we've got a new partnership here with Gym Reapers. So these guys make some awesome gym equipment, gym lifting equipment. So like belts, straps, you know, anything like that, your knee wraps, your elbow sleeves, knee sleeves, anything like that. So check them out, guys. I'll put the link in the description for this. You know, I've already been using some of their products. If you watch some of my videos deadlifting, I'm using their belts, I've been using their straps. So to have kind of an official partnership and be able to, you know, use more of their equipment and them promote and me promote them and them kind of help me out is going to be great. So I'm really looking forward to that, working more closely with them. So very exciting thing as well. But yeah, let's get into this back workout. We're going to start just with probably the strap, just like a pullover, something to get everything warmed up, and then we'll work into the bigger stuff. So let's go. Yeah, try it, see if you like it. If not, we can go to the Vulcan strap. I used it for tricep pushdowns yesterday and I kind of liked it, so we'll try that.
Is this heavy?
Nope. Good. Kind of like best of both worlds, a rope and a bar. It's kind of nice, eh?
I just think you can split it as well.
You can split it pretty far, no? I don't know if anyone saw as well, but another exciting thing for Melissa is she's going to be working with my clothing sponsor, TBJP, so Trained by JP Clothing, actually doing design for them. So not in an athlete capacity really, but actually helping them design a female line as well as some male stuff as well. So she's right on that already. So they're gonna look to do their first launch for, I think, her line kind of in the spring sometime.
Yeah.
So super exciting. I mean, you know, she's been really into, you know, gym fashion. This is something that really interested her. So to be able to kind of do that, you know, in this capacity with JP, who's someone we already know and trust, and a company I already work with, so it's like, it'll be kind of cool that I'll potentially get to wear clothes that my wife designed. Is pretty cool, so yeah, we're really looking forward to that as well.
Now I'm gonna make money from my online shopping addiction, you know what I mean? Like, I'm obsessed with fashion, and now I can design it and make some money, and then spend it all again.
Yeah. Good. Six, perfect. Seven, good. Push down far. There we go. Eight, good. Nine, let's go. 10, two more. Last one, keep the form. Squeeze, 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 squeeze. Good.
The handle's nice, actually.
Huh?
The handle's nice.
It's good, eh? Yeah. On the top, so
yeah,
you don't.
This is scary too.
What?
I don't know.
It's not gonna catch you.
Actually, yeah, you're right. That's
the
not
ball
scary.
Bearings don't come through, so you're okay.
Because I'm like holding up there. You're gonna kill me. This is the regular stuff?
Yeah. Ready?
I want to see what you
put in there. One less. You did 100, right?
Sometimes you go heavier without telling me. A little sneaky, sneaky.
All right, control this, let's go. One, good. Full stretch, two. Three, good. Four, good. Five. All from the lot, come on. Six. Seven, let's go. Eight. Nine, one more, come on. Squeeze, 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 squeeze.
That was like 100-0 very quickly.
Sure, now you guys have seen enough of my back training to know that some kind of pullover variation is basically always what I start with. A couple of reasons for this. One, I find it's a good exercise that puts you through a good plane of motion for a full stretch and a really good tight contraction. So you get a really good range. Also, I find in terms of really activating the lat in the motion, for me, that's the weakest. It's definitely done a lot, and like, and especially for my front shots, my front lat, my front double, really like activating those lats so that I can contract them the way that I can actually feel them through that pose has made a big, big difference for me. So it's just an exercise I feel really good, puts a good range of motion, and really gets those lats activated for the rest of it. So yeah, they've been a staple of my training, you know, as my first predominant movement for quite a while now, so.
I remember when I was young, I can't remember who it was. It might have been Candace Keen or Aaron Stern.
Yeah.
And she was like, I never understood people that like want to be wide but don't do pullovers. She's like, how are you gonna be wide from the front and never do a pullover?
Yeah.
And it's so true because it's like so much.
It's definitely done the most in terms of one, activating the lat through, like I said, that full range of motion. So going into the rest of the workout, I can feel it in that way that I can really connect with. And two, also, you know, from an actual visual standpoint, you know, really reflecting directly into poses, what this has done, you know, for actual width and volume to my lat versus like doing a row or a pull down, has been very noticeably different.
It's like
for me,
lat thickness from the front almost.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. I mean, like you watch guys like Dorian Yates that were huge believers in like the old school Cybex like chain pullover, which are great as well. I prefer honestly doing them with like a rope or a bar or something like that over the Cybex ones. But I mean, if you have one of those, like a machine pullover, they're awesome too. But it's really what, you know, personal preference, what you feel the best. But any pullover motion like that is really good. Or you can do it also with a dumbbell or dumbbell if you band the dumbbell so you get tension consistently through the full range of motion. But a lot of different ways you can do pullover variations. This is just the one that we really like. So.
Let me guess, a row.
Let me guess a row.
Row, row, row.
All right, so we finished up with the pullovers there. We just did a couple straight sets, kind of aimed in that like 12 to 15 range. We got some sound effects in the back. So we're done there, just a couple straight sets. Now we're gonna move on to this Rogers row. We're gonna just do it with a normal, I guess this would be what, pronated grip. So we're gonna just do one top set here, and then we're gonna do a back off set with, I think we have a rest pause on here. So two sets here, top set, rest pause set. So we'll start working up in our small warm-ups and then get to the big sets. Good. You think you can do three? We're gonna put our 5 week out strength to the test here with three plates. So we finished up on the Rogers row. We did both arms at the same time with a pronated grip, so it makes it a little tougher. I've only ever actually used that machine in kind of like more of a neutral grip, one arm at a time, more simulate like a dumbbell row. So we want to simulate more kind of like a barbell row a wider grip roll like that with a new the pronated grip. So tried that out, felt pretty good. It got a little hard to keep yourself in the machine. Both arms pulling that angle kind of want to pull you out. So I don't know, maybe you need someone pushing you down or a seatbelt of some kind, but overall works pretty good if you control the reps. But worked really slow. So we did a top set. I think we were both kind of what, 10, 12, something like that. And then we
did barely eight.
Oh yeah, you went pretty heavy. She did three plates.
Six and a half reps.
She did three plates.
And then I was like fucking done.
And then we did a second set with a single rest pause. So just rested 15 seconds, repeat again to failure. So failure, 15 seconds, repeat to failure. So now we're gonna go on to the Prime Extreme row here. This is one I'd never honestly really used until we've been at this gym. I love it. I'm sure anyone that has this at the gym know how awesome a piece it is. So, and with any of these prime pieces, like I've said in any of the videos, you can kind of pick where you want the load to be. So, you can put more weight at the bottom, make it harder at the top of the movement, middle of the movement, bottom of the movement, whatever. So we're just gonna overload the middle for now. It's kind of more just like the middle ground of it all. And then go by how that feels, then we can kind of overload top to bottom based off there. So we'll start from there. One tip I found that really helped me a lot, as my back was a big weak point for me for a long time, is just when I focus on pulling any movements, I focus on trying to pull from my pinky through the movement. I found when I tried to pull from the front of my hand, I would engage more bicep. When I would try and pull more from the back of my hand, from my pinky, I would engage more lat or rhomboid or whatever, and pull more with my elbow into my back. So that's just one trick. Like there, I would kind of almost let my first two fingers be a little more limp, and I kind of pull from my back ones. Same thing with any rowing movement or pull down movement. Even if I'm doing like a pull down, I kind of focus on these two fingers and pull out with those and not in with my front two. So it's just a trick, kind of a mental trick I use to help really engage my back and my lat. So try it out. Let's go. One, two, good. Pinky, three, good. Four, drive apart. Five, good. Six, good. Seven, come on. Eight, two more. One more, finish it. Good. That's it. Come on. Steve, lean forward. Lean forward more. Two, good. Head up, chest up. Three, good. Four, good. Five, come on. Six, good. Seven, come on. Eight, let's go. Nine, two more. One more, come on, finish it. You think I can full stack this or what? We'll find out in a minute. I'll embarrass myself or I'll do it. Set.
And 15 reps.
15-ish.
14.75.
All right, so can't remember if I recap, we did that prime row, the top set there, and then the single rest pause. And then we just did this cable row with the mag grip there, like the medium mag grip, so they have a bunch of different variations. This is kind of the one in the middle, they got narrow, super, super wide. We did kind of the medium one there. Just straight sets on this one, no intensifiers. A heavier top set with like 8 to 10, and then we did a little bit of a back off. Now we're gonna head and do some kind of high pull. So we'll probably do that on the cable, just a single arm. And then we have like a wide grip pull up. Or we might do the assisted wide grip pull up, like a body weight pull up with the assisted thing. So get onto those. But first, the high pull. All right, I've just winged this one for some kind of makeshift high pull variation. So I guess we could have done it sitting on the seat, but then it's kind of really directly above you. So I'm just kneeling a little farther back, so it's more kind of in front, more mimicking a high pull, like one of the hammer strength high pulls, high rows. So it works pretty good. I mean, you might, if it's a little uncomfortable on the floor, you might want to get a mat. It's not like the super most comfortable, but the range of motion feels good. So.
Strength is so bad.
One. Two. Good. come on.
I have something funny to tell you about that after.
Good, I just hold on this like a handle.
Oh yeah.
I should have said it earlier. Alright, so. Two, good. Drive from the pin. Three, good. Nice engagement. Good. Four. Hard down. Five. Good. Six. Come on. Eight. Good. Nine. Come on. Three more. One, two more. Two, one more. Finish it. Good.
Did you just ring it?
Yeah. Technical error.
Thank you.
Come on. One more. Shit. All right, guys, so that's a wrap on back there. I guess we're, like I said, 8 days out now. So we're gonna have our last quad day tomorrow. We're gonna film that for you. And then we fly out to Columbus Tuesday morning early. And then we're gonna have Christian with us next week to film our entire week in Columbus. So it's gonna get some really good content for you guys. But yeah, I mean, this is gonna be super exciting. This is my first Arnold. So this is a whole new experience for me as well, as you know, so I want to document it for everybody. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this workout. If you have any questions about anything, toss in the comments as usual. And you know, make sure to check out Gym Reapers. Like I said, I put the their link for their social media and their website and everything in the bio. I'll have a discount code for you guys as well, so I'll put that down there as well. But yeah, hope you guys enjoy. We'll see you tomorrow.